Hi, my name is Wan. I'm a coach based in Singapore. In this sharing, I'm going to share about my leadership podcast talk with Wan. Leadership is a very huge area, so I'm going to share about what is the vision and mission of the podcast. What's behind this project and probably the current focus for the podcast? As I shared, the leadership area is a huge area. So for the podcast, the vision is to encourage every professional to be the leader in the area he or she passionate about. And the mission is to share diverse perspective on leadership, helping professional to shift to be authentic leaders. And what's behind this podcast? What's the background? From my experience, I find many people assume a leader is someone with a title and probably power as well. Hopefully, in this podcast, you will share experience of diverse leaders from different perspective. And second observation I have about leaders and leadership is many organizations are concentrating on knowledge, leadership models, and competency. And what about in the world of worker? Volatility, uncertainty, complex and ambiguity. And that's why I hope through this podcast it help us to take a look of alternative way of leadership development. And the current focus of this podcast, Talk You One, is about vertical leadership development. I'm going to share with a model shared by Nick. In his article, he said there are seven stages of vertical leadership development. The first stage is opportunist. That's where we are in the beginning of our career. We are very much focused on our own needs, our own development, and very much about ourselves. The second stage is conformer. That's also where we are when we start in the early stage of career, where we very much would like to feel safe by following the rules, conforming to norms, so that through this conformity, we hope to move ahead in our career. Then we realize that the third stage is expert. We realize that one way to deliver values is to be the domain expert in the area that we have chosen. We spend a lot of time to gather more knowledge, skills, and model. The fourth stage is achiever. So besides gaining knowledge and skills, we also concentrate on goals, achievement, and meeting the high standards. like some of the high achievers, their focus is very much on the results and meeting the goals. The fifth stage is self-questioning. That is a stage where we start to have questions about our model, being conformer, expert, or achiever. And this stop may develop for a few months, up to a few years, before we realize that to move forward, to be more effective, to be a better leader, we probably need to be a strategist where we not only considering personal development and organization development, we also consider the system's perspective. What is the effect of our action on the community and society where we are working with? And the seventh stage is synergies. The leader will combine both skills, knowledge, together with ability to adapt, handling more complexity in a harmonious manner. And you may wonder why the focus on vertical leadership development. I want to share an article in Forbes. The title is What Leaders Can Expect in 2021. And one of the statements is, the big idea is to ready yourself and your team of leaders to lead in an uncertain world, a walkover, by engaging in political leadership development. So what it means, in a world where there's high uncertainty, there is a premium on the ability to handle complexity and to be more adaptive. It's like not only you try to fill the cup, but you also try to expand the cup in terms of development. And there's some information about vertical leadership development and the reason behind it. I hope you enjoy our discussion and dialogue in Talk with One Leadership Podcast.